Connecticut headquarters of the ARRL. He had been Connecticut Section Communications Manager for 6 years during the 70s and 80s. In his long association with the League, he also held executive roles, for a time serving as an assistant director for New England's division director. Pete Kim, who most recently was living in Wesley Chapel, Florida, became a silent key on May 17th. Not only was he a licensed amateur for 47 years, he also authored one of the ARRL's publications, A Teacher's Guide to Amateur Radio Instruction. An educator by profession, he had a polished way of imparting knowledge, and it earned him Connecticut's award as Technology Teacher of the Year. He also became the ARRL's first educational advisor. A retiree from the Bethel, Connecticut public school system, Kemp could be found as well in the classrooms at Central Connecticut State University as an adjunct member of the faculty. The ARRL's Connecticut section manager, Betsy Doan, K1EIFM, remembers him as, quote, a superb teacher in the high school, a wonderful mentor, licensed over 700 hams, an active member of Candlewood Amateur Radio Association, and one who really understood what it meant to actualize his potential, end quote. And an amateur radio friend of his, Bill Barrett, KW1B, called him, quote, a good soul with a gentle nature, end quote. Pete Kemp was 67. In the world of DX, as the Wireless Institute of Australia prepares for its annual general meeting and conference on Norfolk Island, a team of Australian amateurs are activating the island through May 31st, working as VK9NT. Listen for them on all bands from 160 meters to 10 meters, working CW, SSB, and RTTY. Be listening to during the meeting weekend for the WIA's commemorative station, VI9ANZAC. Other stations operating will include VK9WI and VK9WIA. Ollie, OH0XX, is activating PZ50X from...